Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2018 Malaysian military action film called, Pascal, the Movie. Spoilers ahead. Seat back, relax and enjoy the video. The movie begins in the Gulf of Aden in 2018, we see Navy soldiers talking about finally being able to go home when an alarm goes off. Two pirate boats are approaching Laurel 11. The captain of the ship informs everyone on the ship, while Commander Mosnan informs the fleet commander of their situation. After giving the instructions to Commander Mosnan, the fleet commander asks for information about the ship. The pirates boarded the ship. The captain orders the crew to assemble at the citadel where they will hide, and switch off all the lights in the ship. Unfortunately, the crew that's left to switch off the power falls unconscious while running to the citadel. Upon seeing the pirates near them, the captain has no choice but to close the door. At the Navy ships, the soldiers are preparing for the operation. Upon getting all the information about the ship, the fleet commander permits them to proceed. The pirates, on the other hand, reach the captain's deck when Commander Mosnan calls. The pirates ask for $20 million in exchange for the lives of the people on the ship. Then, they move to get a hostage. Meanwhile, at the mothership of the pirates, they spotted the helicopter of the Navy and shoot at them. Upon getting permission to shoot to kill, the sniper takes out the helmsman of the pirates, causing them to retreat. Back on the Laurel 11, the pirates notice their mother boat leaving. One of them wants to leave, but the rest wants to continue. Not knowing that the Navy already boarded the ship, the pirates are taken down one by one. The crew that was left behind gains his consciousness back. Thinking fast, he grabs an axe and hides. He, then, attacks the pirate that comes his way, but the other pirate points his gun at him. The Navy arrives, and the pirate takes the man hostage. But another Navy attacks the pirate from behind, taking him down. The captain gets out of hiding, and introduces himself. It's a successful mission for the Navy. Then, we see a Navy soldier named, Armin Rommet, finishing his resignation letter. However, he hesitates to click send. Outside, the soldiers are being greeted by their families, but Armin is greeted by no one. He comes home, and finds his mother unconscious on the table. Finding her medicines, his mother dismisses him, showing that the two have an unstable relationship. Night falls, he sees blood in his mother's laundry. He's about to ask her about it, but changes his mind. His mother, then, suddenly tells him that she already bought a burial place near his late father's burial place. She also mentions that if it wasn't for a woman named Lily, she would already be dead, and that Armin and his late father are just the same. In his room, Armin looks at the photo on the table. A photo of him with two other soldiers. Then, we see a flashback of his training days to be part of Pascal. He meet Joshua and Jeb. During their training, Armin shows good performance and constantly tops his class. Unfortunately, this doesn't make Jeb happy. During their training, one of the trainees gives up. In their quarters, the trainees talk about that one person who gives up. Armin, then, sees Joshua looking at a photo of his girlfriend, Lily. The training continues, until we see them finally complete their basic course. At the awarding ceremony, Armin receives the Best Recruit Award in Commando Pascal Basic Course, which again annoys Jeb. Even after the ceremony, Armin's mother didn't show up. Joshua calls him, and asks him to join the photo with him and his girlfriend. Afterward, Commander Mosnan informs Armin and Joshua, that they have been chosen to train with the SEAL team, together with Jeb. The scene changes to Armin accompanying Joshua and Lily on their date. They're currently buying the wedding ring for Lily, but Joshua's money is short, so he borrows money from Armin. Then, it cuts to Angola in 2011. Armin, Joshua, and Jeb are accompanying a China UN observer, Sergeant Chen Han, in a peacekeeping mission when the truck in front of them gets ambushed. Although they didn't bring a gun with them, which pisses Jeb, the three step out of the car while Chen calls for backup. When the attackers see them, they run and hide. The soldiers take the opportunity to rescue the civilians in the truck. But Armin notices that someone is still left behind. The two go back, but the attackers realize that they don't have any weapons, and decide to shoot at them. The two, along with the wounded civilian, hide in cover. Fortunately, the backup arrives, and shoots back at the attackers. Jeb runs to one of the backup soldiers, takes his gun, and shoots back at the enemies. He then, throws a grenade, as Armin and Joshua continue to run back to the car. But the enemy picks up the grenade and throws it back. Upon seeing it, Joshua takes the blow, sacrificing his life for Armin and then the wounded civilian. Angered, Jeb charges and kills the remaining attackers, even the one that already surrendered. In the base, Jeb and Commander Mosnan are arguing because of what Jeb did, while Armin is outside, silently mourning the death of his friend. In the end, Jeb has been dishonorably discharged from the service. Before leaving, he tells Armin to leave as well before he becomes the next victim of what he said is a useless system. Afterward, Armin and Commander Mosnan inform Lily of Joshua's death, which breaks her heart. Then, they bury Joshua, giving him an honorable burial for his service to the country. The scene changes back to the present, and he finally sends his resignation letter. The next day, Armin and his mother visit Lily and her child, Joey. They accompany Armin's mother in her medical checkup. While waiting and watching Joey play, Armin and Lily talk about Armin and Joshua's job. Lily expresses her frustrations that they get nothing in return for their service to the country. Armin then changes the topic and reveals to her that he pays half of the price of the ring, lightening up the mood around them. Afterward, Armin goes to Commander Mosnan and talks about his resignation. Instead of fully resigning, Commander Mosnan tells him that he will just assign him as a trainer. However, before doing so, he asks Armin to participate in a mission for the last time, as his farewell party, to which he agrees. Their mission is to capture the leader of a pirate group named Rudy Rusli Parjo. Rudy will have a transaction with an unknown contact in a Filipino market, and they are ordered to capture them both. The scene changes to the Filipino market. Armin and his team are already scattered in the market, posing as civilians. When Rudy enters the market, they keep an eye on him, but a vendor notifies Rudy of them tailing him. Armin orders Misai, one of his men, to follow Rudy, but he lost him as foreigners distract him, asking for directions. Armin takes over and looks for him, but is surprised to see Rudy meets with Jeb. The two look in his direction, and Armin calls for a retreat as their cover has been blown. In the base, the Armin squads, along with Commander Mosnan, talk about Jeb. Armin points out how difficult it would be for them to capture Rudy now because he has Jeb on his side, a former PASCAL member who knows their standard operating procedure. Then, we see Lily and Joey in their house. A car arrives, thinking that it is Armin. Joey goes out to greet him. However, we see Armin arriving. Lily greets him. She tells him that someone is in their house, and Jeb greets Armin as he walks inside. The two old friends talk outside. Jeb shows Armin how rich he is, after not working for the Navy anymore, and not following the system. Armin checks Jeb's car, and he asks Armin to join him, but Armin declines. Before leaving, Jeb threatens Armin to not get in his way, or else he might accidentally kill him as well. Armin quickly calls Commander Mosnan, and informs him about Jeb. He tells him to track his phone. It turns out that while checking Jeb's car, he dropped his phone inside. Commander Mosnan tells him to not get involved, but he declines because Lily and Joey get involved. After getting the approval of Commander Mosnan, Armin follows Jeb. Unfortunately, Jeb notices his phone, and throws it on the sidewalk where Armin finds it. As he picks it up, he notices something at the back. He quickly throws it upward before it explodes, wounding his face in the process. Frustrated, he gets home and opens an email from the commander. There is an attached video recording from a security camera of Jeb. The next day, Jeb meets with Rudy and goes with them. Meanwhile, Lily brought Joey to Armin's house before leaving for work. Joey wakes Armin up, then Armin's mother calls Joey for breakfast. She then talks to her son, frustrated that he's not resigning from his job yet. After his mother leaves, Armin continues his research, and something caught his attention. Calling the security number of an oil rig company, and confirming Jeb's presence, he immediately notifies them that their security was breached. The scene changes to Lily, arriving in the oil rig company. Then, we see Jeb and Rudy in security personnel uniforms. The two are targeting the oil rig company where Lily works. Back to Armin, he notifies Commander Mosnan, to which he immediately orders his men to lock down the company, and arrest Jeb and Rudy. The company is also notified of the presence of pirates. The security, along with other authorities, manages to capture some of them. Unfortunately, Jeb and Rudy already escaped. Back to Lily, they hear a security announcement telling them to go to the assembly hall. It turns out that the announcer is one of Rudy's men, making their job easier in capturing everyone. Meanwhile, Armin tries to call Lily, but when she answers, Jeb and Rudy arrive, taking them as hostages. Jeb recognizes Lily, and takes her phone. He then tells Armin that they want 100 million by morning next day. He also threatens Armin that he will kill Lily if he tries to play the hero. After the call, Commander Mosnan tells him to leave the operations to them, but he declines. After assuring that his squad will come, the commander agrees. Armin then calls everyone in his squad, to which they all comply, arrive on time. After the preparation, they board the plane. Meanwhile, other pirates have arrived to back up Rudy and Jeb. After Armin and his squad jump out of the plane, they meet with Commander Mosnan in a submarine. The scene changes to a meeting room where higher officials are talking about the situation. The fleet commander convinces them that they can resolve the problem without giving a single dollar to the pirates. Then, they are permitted to carry out their operation. Armin is given the authority to lead the mission. Knowing the fact that Jeb will know their standard operating procedure, Armin decides to change their course of action. Back in the oil rig, the hostages are being taken when Lily talks bad about Jeb. Pissed off, Jeb pushes her. Her workmate tries to stop Jeb, but he gets beaten down by him. Afterward, at 3:15 a.m., the Navy makes their move. A bag floats in front of the pirates, thinking that it is an enemy, they blindly shoot at it. But the Navy is going underneath them. By 4 a.m., they successfully manage to sneak into the oil rig without anyone noticing them. They silently take down the pirates one by one, until one of the pirates gets alerted, and shoots back at them. By 4:15 a.m., the shootout begins. Rudy gets out to fight, and tries to take down the sniper, but fails. Going back inside, he notifies Jeb about the situation and plans to bring them to the wormhole. By 4:30 a.m., other soldiers arrive. After Armin gives the instructions, they move out. As they enter the facility, they check every room. But as one soldier is about to open another door, the pirates inside shoot through the walls. As the soldiers blindly shoot back through the walls, Rudy appears and shoots at them. Fortunately, the Navy successfully clears every room. Rudy, then, contacts Jeb, and tells him that he can't stay anymore. In the control room, Jeb turns off the lights, then throws an explosive device to Armin and his men before leaving. Armin and his men continue. Entering a room full of hostages, they see that the room is full of hand grenades as well, connected to a thin wire. One wrong move, it will all explode. Armin looks for Lily in the crowd of hostages, but she's not there. One of his men tells him to continue searching for her, while he will help the hostages, and cut all the wires connected to the grenades. As they continue, they're now scanning every room for possible bomb traps. Finding another room with a bomb and hostages, he successfully rescues them by throwing the grenade to the other room before it explodes. One of the hostages is Lily's friend, and he tells Armin that Lily was held hostage by Jeb, himself. Armin continues the search, and he brought one of his men, Polar, with him. Unfortunately, Polar is killed by a remote-controlled machine gun that Jeb sets off when they open a door. By 6:15 a.m. Armin finds Lily with a C4 bomb attached to her body. Jeb, then, appears with a gun and the detonator in his hands. Other soldiers are coming, but Jeb detonates one of the bombs planted on their way, leaving Armin with no choice but to put his guns down. Then, Jeb attacks Armin, and challenges him to know who the best Pascal is. The two brawls, although Armin is putting up a fight, Jeb is stronger. Rudy, on the other hand, escapes along with one other pirate using a lifeboat. Other Navy soldiers chase them. Commander Mosnan orders them to take Rudy down before he crosses the Philippine waters or else they'll lose jurisdiction. Fortunately, they are able to kill Rudy and the other pirate before they cross the boundary to the Philippines. The scene changes back to Armin and Jeb fighting, and they're both wounded. Armin smartly targets Jeb's legs, but Jeb is still prideful. The two struggle with a knife, but Armin manages to push Jeb on the edge. Armin, then, grabs Jeb's hand, but Jeb laughs at him, pulls out a gun, and shoots him in the face. This causes Armin to fall, letting go of Jeb as he falls to his death. Luckily Armin lives, and just has a wound in his face from the shot. The man left earlier to cut all the wires also successfully rescued the hostages, and throws a grenade before it explodes. Another successful mission for Armin and his team. At the Royal Malaysian Navy base, Joey runs to Lily, and his mother greets him and finally understands the importance of his job. She also tells him that if his father is still alive, he would be proud of him. The scene changes to Armin, and his team being awarded by the fleet commander. Afterward, he takes him to a memorial of their fallen comrades. Armin sees the name of Joshua written there, showing that their sacrifice for the country is not wasted and unrecognized. The fleet commander, then, reveals that Armin's father used to report to him directly when he was still alive, saying that their job is a calling from God. The movie ends with the fleet commander thanking Armin for his service as Armin salutes. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Have a nice day.